If we wait for it to work itself out, it will never be worked out. Freedom only comes through persistent revolt, through persistent agitation, through persistently rising up against the system of evil. Don't sit down and do nothing, because if you stop now, we will be in the dungeons of segregation and discrimination for another 100 years. That is where the strong resistance comes. We've got to keep on keeping on.
It's about immigrant rights. All of them helped build the unions in this country. And today in Los Angeles, we are standing shoulder to shoulder with immigrant rights groups, civil rights groups, to say we are one movement, we are united, and we will not stop marching until dignity and respect is given to all.
Martin Luther King said in the 60s that an injustice here is an injustice everywhere.
Soy Janitor, orgullosa de ser Janitor. Y yo voy representándolo a todos los trabajadores para que logremos una legalización.
Ellos están conscientes de los riesgos que están tomando. Sin embargo, están dispuestos a hacer ese sacrificio por los derechos de todos los inmigrantes en este país. Le agradecemos mucho por lo que están haciendo. ¡Se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
¡Se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
Tenemos la inspiración de muchas otras personas que han trabajado por nosotros anteriormente, desde años atrás.
Es un movimiento que estamos haciendo para que muchos de nuestros compatriotas tengan derechos en los lugares de trabajo y tengan, se les respete sus derechos, los derechos civiles, y que también tengan la oportunidad de reunir sus familias. Porque en lo personal estuve 8 años sin ver a mis hijos.
Yo soy un simple trabajador también y venimos aquí a apoyar aquí a la gente aquí.
Estamos aquí reunidos para la marcha para nuestros hijos, para que le den sus papeles, cuidados, escuelas, aseguranzas, los derechos que tiene el emigrante igual que el que tiene el ciudadano. Por eso estamos aquí reunidos.
Se ve, se siente, el pueblo está presente. Se ve, se siente, el pueblo está presente.
Mucho riesgo lo que corre uno, todo por venir también para buscar un futuro mejor. Y lo que se encuentra uno que es peor también, como lo tratan uno en sus trabajos, que no hay respeto, no hay dignidad, los salarios que son muy bajos. Nosotros hacemos los trabajos más pesados. ¿Quién los hace? Los inmigrantes.
Yo tengo 13 años de trabajar en el hotel y yo no sabía nada de lo que era sindicato, yo no tenía la menor idea. Pero cuando empecé a ver injusticias. Yo empecé a participar a la Unión y a escuchar y a participar en todas las acciones. Todos los días quieren faltar el respeto a los trabajadores. Y si no tuviéramos la Unión, fuera peor. Por eso digo, la Unión hace la fuerza y sí se puede.
I do believe.
Overcome in Spanish, someday.
We shall overcome someday. I'll go ahead. Deep in my heart, I do believe. We shall overcome someday.
We shall overcome.
You know, this country has a history of building its wealth on the back of immigrant workers and slavery.
That's right.
This is not a new thing. We must continue to walk, we must continue to fight, we must continue to go forward. We cannot let it continue in this country. God bless you.
And the other side is Mexico, and the other side of that is Mexico.
Aquí en Nogales, Arizona, Nogales, Sonora. Aquí estamos en la barda que nos divide como comunidad, bardas que no existían anteriormente. Ahora ya ven, ya no se puede cruzar, no se permite la cruzada, sino que les han obligado a la gente irse a los lugares más peligrosos, donde la gente muere de los calores, deshidratación, falta de alimentos. Antes no morían estas gentes aquí. Nunca habíamos tenido gente que tenía que morir. Pero ahora, como política, se han obligado de irse a los lados de esta muralla horrible.
Me dio mucha tristeza cuando yo agarré la cruz, porque yo no sé si esta persona desconocida puede ser un padre de familia que dejó sus hijos, o un hijo que dejó a su madre y que no saben qué pasó con él. Y es triste, es como madre, si a mí se me pierde un hijo de esta manera, o sea, no sé cómo se puede soportar. Todos los ranchos de donde yo soy de Zacatecas, México, y yo sufrí que mi padre nos dejara por años, él estando aquí trabajando en el campo. Y uno como hijo allá sufre mucho, mucho. Y lo que más espera uno es la llegada de su padre. Entonces puede ser que esta persona dejó hijos que nunca lo volvieron a ver. Es triste.
But I mean, that was a shock to me, that people getting killed like that, trying to be free.
Guerra contra la compañía cuando los querían separar de los güeros y los hispanos.
Sí.
Explícale.
Pues era que no tenían los baños para después del trabajo y ni baño para ir. Tenemos que ir abajo de una piedra o abajo de un árbol. Todos los mexicanos.
¿Y los americanos?
Ellos sí tenían todo lo que...
Los servicios.
Los sepas. Y no hicimos la película South of the Earth. Al mismo tiempo peleándole a la compañía que estaban en huelga con ella, ganamos todas las demandas que pedimos.
Pueblo, escucha, estamos en la lucha. Pueblo, escucha, estamos en la lucha.
Movimiento.
Orgulloso porque sé que estoy aprendiendo algo de ellos, que van a hacer algo por nosotros.
Es nuestra oportunidad para que nos escuchen, para que sepan que existimos, porque es triste que el censo diga que somos 6,000 habitantes cuando ya somos 15,000 habitantes y cada día está creciendo más. Entonces es una oportunidad que vamos a tener muy en cuenta, ¿verdad?, para que sepan que existimos, que somos gente, que trabajamos, que luchamos y que estamos dispuestas a superar.
Follow whatever they tell you to do, but say absolutely nothing. Don't deny anything, don't agree with anything, don't say no, don't say yes. Absolutely nothing. And if they begin questioning you again in person, all you do is hold up your card for them. Show them your card.
We have this because we're saying that we're all going to stand in solidarity. We're going to be silent because it doesn't really matter who has documents or who's not. We're all here in the same struggle, and we all believe, you know, in the same cause. So what it says is, to whom it may concern, I'm a participant in the Immigrant Workers Freedom Ride, a peaceful campaign by citizens and immigrants in support of equal rights for all workers. I wish to exercise my right to remain silent.
We have a very difficult time in organizing. We're so close to the border. We started an organizing campaign. They'll call me at home, call me on my cell phone. This is the corporate managers, supervisors, telling me that if I continue to try to organize their plants, we will shut the place down, move it to Mexico.
Y son 40 pesos.
40 pesos o 40 dólares?
40 dólares.
Okay,
por horas.
Por horas.
Sí. Y por contrato saca más, unos 50 o 60 pesos.
O sea que tiene que trabajar duro para poder con más cajas. Cuanto más cajas es, más ganas. O sea que no puedes tomar ni almuerzo, ni descanso, ni nada.
Único defensor, que en paz descanse, fueron César Chávez.
Necesitamos más César Chávez y usted puede ser uno de ellos.
Sí, todo está. Ya.
La voz de Dios nos duele. Vengo al mundo, grita la gente. El amor de Dios no acaba, ni la voz de Dios se pierde.
I know my rights.
Es más que el mensaje que traía yo de Tucson, hay mucho más a través de donde estamos pasando. Todos tenemos necesidades, todos necesitamos de esto que estamos haciendo. Y pues esperemos que vamos a hacerlo bien y que traigamos resultados.
Sí.
Y pues, como último.
This is another tough day with regards to the Border Patrol, right? We all know this is one of those days when we're more likely than not because of a permanent checkpoint, right?
As long as your light's shining in your heart, we got hope. That's what the song means. It's an old slave song. It's all right. Very easy. This little light of mine,
I'm gonna let it shine. This little light. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
undocumented immigration check. She needs to turn that camera off, please.
Okay, I've asked her to turn it off. She's a member of the press. I want to tell you that we're members of the Immigrant Workers Freedom Ride.
Okay, now just understand that you're at an immigration checkpoint.
I understand.
Okay, and we're going to conduct an immigration check on your passengers. Now, when I ask an individual for his citizenship, that individual needs to specify whether he's an American citizen or what type of immigration documentation he may have.
Morning, U.S. Border Patrol checkpoint, Sierra Blanca, Texas. If you're not a citizen of the United States, please show me any immigration documents that you have. Everybody will be asked for citizenship.
Going to try to break the action, essentially. I mean, they're going to try to get one person to talk to them by scaring them and threatening them.
We are not afraid today. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome today.
Not afraid.
She's back inside. All right. They didn't break her down. They didn't break her down. All right, Sandra.
We shall overcome.
All right, Sandra.
We shall overcome today.
All right, girl.
You can't line up outside. It's not okay with him. We need to move on. He insists that we have everybody, and I've told him, and I've gotten permission to come back if we don't. He needs us to move up the road, and he's unbudging on it.
Okay.
So everybody stays. We move up to Sierra Blanca. We reconnect.
Okay.
Okay.
Where is it going?
Lo mismo que íbamos a hacer allá, lo vamos a hacer aquí. We don't know, we have to check and make sure that everybody is with us and nobody stayed behind. Incredible human beings like you. There are many, many more across this country. And we're going to go on to the rest of the route and to New York City.
Esto que sentí ahorita fue una gran conmoción en mi vida. Y creo que este es el principio de una gran lucha. Y yo estoy más fuerte que nunca para seguir luchando por todas las injusticias que hay. Y estoy fuerte, fuerte, fuerte.
This ride is something that is bigger than the individuals that's on this bus. You know, we're representing some 30 million people who, you know, are disenfranchised in this country, and it's overwhelming.
Estoy muy nerviosa. Y cuando nos pararon y nos tuvieron ahí por 3 horas y media, me dieron más nervios. Ya no sabía ni qué iba a pasar. Cuando nos bajaron, cuando mirábamos que a los carros de al lado los hacían al lado, un señor cuando los subieron al carro de inmigración y se los llevaron. Me recordaba mucho de lo que miramos de la gente, de los trabajadores, de todo que por lo que hemos pasado, por los pueblos que hemos pasado. Y bueno, nomás seguimos con la solidaridad y todos juntos.
The first thing that I thought about was my mother and my father, when they crossed one of the times, they were detained. And as I was sitting in that cell, I was thinking, this is what it must have felt for them. This is what it must have looked for them. There was like 9 of us crammed in this little cell that we couldn't even all sit. You know, so some of us were just standing, but mostly chanting, you know. So even though it was a moment of excitement and joy, you know, that we were organized and doing that stuff, for myself, it was also a moment of reflection of just, you know, what my family has gone through.
Along the entry of the doorway, people, you know, immigrants before had etched their names in, and it just made me wonder, you know, where are all those immigrants now? What happened to them? Have they been killed? Have they been deported? Did they succeed? Were they able, you know, to come back and cross into the U.S.?
Se me vino a la mente las cruces de Nogales. Pensé en la cruz que me dieron, que me asignaron a mí para que la lleve a Washington. Esa cruz con el nombre de Adriana. Y sentí valor y sentí coraje.
As you've united us tonight with this wonderful group of people who have come so far and yet need to go so long. Their journey that represents the journey of all of us. The journey that all of us long for justice. The journey that all of us long for freedom. The journey that all of us long for peace.
We shall overcome. tiene el huecat. Te opesente cote en atzala. Ya yo lo mi en tlaxekpak. Tota tiene el huecat.
Been taking it every time.
Oh,
oh. Okay, but I,
oh my God.
Yeah.
Buenos días, todos. Buenos días.
Even though I was arrested yesterday in Sierra Blanco detention, I did not cry. But now I feel crying because of a lot of supporters.
El compromiso del Departamento de Policía en Austin es a servir y a proteger la comunidad inmigrante.
We have taken the stand that we will not stop, detain, and arrest people solely on immigration status.
Yes!
When we heard about what happened to you in El Paso, okay, went to the Capitol, spoke with legislators, spoke with politicians, made phone calls, got faxes, called in all of our shots that we could to make sure that this that was happening in El Paso would be minimized.
Que estaban cantando en la otra celda, como, a ver, espérense. O sea, no hacíamos ruido nadie. Espérense.
Corten.
Y en cuanto agarrábamos el sonidito, empezábamos bajito, poco a poco. Y empezaba más fuerte, y todos, también los de adelante acá. Say as a rider.
That's when I started stomping, like, down, south, south, south. And we all started stomping, it was like the most beautiful thing I've ever seen in my life.
Nosotros cantábamos, y el otro grupo, que eran el muchacho donde estaba Jorge, me fijé,
yo que estaba Jorge, canción.
Y ellos estaban brincando, estaban ra, ta, ta, ta. Sí. Entonces nosotros también empezamos con el pie también, todo.
Across the hall was our sisters, you know, and they motivated me a lot. And then when we stopped and got tired, we prayed, and then we got back again to the singing, and then we prayed, and then we got back again to the singing. But it was just so beautiful to be, even they broke us apart. I really gotta give it to those girls, because those girls showed me a lot of power when I felt like giving up, you know.
Those people were tough.
I said, it's 5 o'clock, guys. We gotta go.
Oh, no, we called the house.
Martin Luther King Jr. was killed tonight in Memphis, Tennessee. Shot in the face as he stood alone in the balcony of the hotel.
And the staff of the National Civil Rights Museum, you are standing on holy ground. I am so proud that you've organized this freedom ride. I want you to know, even though we've enjoyed a lot of freedoms, we still aren't totally free today, are we? So we have a right to continue to fight for the freedom of all humankind.
It'll take a long time before it will change, but I think it's getting better. And I do believe that if Martin Luther King and Cesar Chavez both were here, they'd be very pleased with us.
I think this is one of the most wonderful historical moments in my life. When I was about 16 years old, I hear that he had been shot, and it was just like a dark cloud. But it didn't stop our hope. We still had hope. I mean, the words that he left, it still lives on to this day. Free at last. Free at last. Thank God Almighty, we're free at last.
Así los estaban a Martin Luther King también. Él también estuvo así arrestado como usted y como yo. Cuando hacemos los picket lines, él también estuvo así arrestado.
They would travel on buses similar to this one in order to fight against Jim Crow, which was a form of segregation. Those that were against the civil rights struggle tried to stop it.
What we have to see happen now is that this Freedom Ride becomes the first part of many campaigns all over the country that put not only the immigration issue on the front burner, but puts poverty on the front burner, minimum wage workers on the front burner. All of these issues must come to the top of the table if our nation is going to be a nation that is really a nation that reflects equality, liberty, justice for all.
Can you give us a message for us, the Freedom Riders, so we can put that in our minds and our souls? Since in the 1960s, the songs were keeping us alive.
Grow into the power, the inward power of nonviolent struggle. And you will find a life of adventure that is astonishing.
How you doing, Mr. Singh?
I'm very fine.
Good.
Nice to see you in Washington, D.C. Oh,
nice meeting you. It's a pleasure for us to be here with you.
Okay, you're most welcome.
I'm part of the Freedom Ride caravan that came here to talk about issues that are affecting our community. Mm-hmm. Not only in our community, but also in every town that we were starting. Our immigrant people, they work, they live, they pay taxes, they contribute to our economy, yet they're denied, they're deprived of the rights to be legalized in this country. I cannot see any better opportunity. That's why, one of the many reasons that I joined this Freedom Ride, you know, to bring to the attention of the government that we're doing something very wrong with our immigrants.
I'm a home care worker. So, and a lot of my coworkers are Latino, so I'm here for them first of all. I'm here to fight for them because they can't be here. They pay taxes, I pay taxes. What is the difference? I get Social Security. When I get older, I'll be able to get Social Security. They won't. What's the difference? That's not fair.
So while we were in Austin, a lady came up to me, and I was just thanking her for coming to show her support. And she was saying, there's something I want to give you. So she pulled out the rosary, and she said that she wanted, even though she had achieved legalization, she wanted to give me this rosary so God could watch over us. And giving me the rosary, she was also placing the hope of all her people in my hands.
Cuando estábamos en Memphis, terminando la actividad que tuvimos ahí, una persona joven y me dijo, es que se los quiero entregar porque este santo, Santo Toribio Romo, es el que nosotros le tenemos fe para que ayude mucho a los emigrantes.
And we have support all over, and we're going for them, we're going for all the people we spoke to, we're going for people we haven't spoke to, we're going for all the people that die crossing the border, the ones that are unknown, and the ones they're still looking for. And we're gonna accomplish something out of this. It's gonna be done.
This is Morristown, Tennessee.
And what's gonna happen here today?
We're gonna have a couple of speeches, then we're gonna have lunch, and we're gonna have a march. It's never happened here before, and it's the first time, so it's gonna be good.
Freedom!
It's not right. Hey, they can go
cheap
back
labor.
Where are they? Cheap labor.
Cheap
they are cheap labor right here.
Traditionally, the jobs in the agricultural and manufacturing industry have been held by African Americans and also by poor Appalachian white people. And so what they do is basically they bring in or open up jobs for immigrant workers, and so none of these jobs are unionized, and so people are basically competing for a very limited number of jobs. People get displaced because immigrant workers end up being able to work for less money.
No queremos ya sufrir aquí, sí. Es lo mucho que sufrimos hasta aquí. Y mira los dedos de 9 años de trabajar, cómo estoy todos mis dedos chuecos. ¿Ve cómo estoy? Y estar y pasa la línea más de 40 minutos. Así tiene que estar usted, Siri. Las 8 horas así. Así, este paso y otro y otro y otro. Y así estamos, oiga, ya. Este brazo lo tengo muy mal. Este pie igualmente, por la frialdad que nos avientan del hielo.
Where? Today is Richmond bound.
And after Richmond?
Washington DC.
Ahora cargo una gran responsabilidad en mí para llegar allá a Washington y decirles todo lo que traigo aquí y aquí.
Washington está al frente
de ustedes. Me siento maravillada. Es un sueño que estoy viviendo. Es un sueño.
Nunca ni en sueños imaginé venir a este país y conocer estas ciudades tan lindas que tiene esta nación. Es impresionante. Es wonderful. Es lindo, lindo, lindo. Y por eso tenemos que pelear duro para mantenernos en esta tierra, para que tengamos derechos, igualdad para todo mundo.
Who are we?
Freedom Riders.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
Yeah, I'm very excited to come to reach here finally after a long journey.
Got something brand new, it's powerful. Look who's up on the stage, African-American kids singing to immigrants who travel from all over the country saying, we're gonna fight together. We're building power in this country and we're not gonna take it anymore.
This is the happiest moment. We did it.
Los Angeles, 110. Satisfied, we will not be at peace until immigrant workers are treated like all other human beings. You have a right to be treated with dignity and with respect.
As a result of your march here today, that we will take action in the Senate of the United States and the House of Representatives, and it'll be a new day for freedom.
Llevo 18 años y como vuelvo a repetir en este país en los cuales yo no he visto a mis primeros hijos.
Damn.
Esto le digo. Uno de estos días, sus hijos van a poder venir aquí porque usted va a tener permiso de traerlos. Y en eso trabajamos muchos de nosotros. De eso, no se le olvide eso, porque eso yo también voy a siempre recordar, que mis padres a mí me trajeron aquí y me dijeron, tú vas a tener mejor vida. Y esto se lo digo a usted, sus hijos van a tener mejor vida porque vinieron ustedes aquí para luchar para ellos. Así que usted vino, la obra que hace hoy es más grande que cualquier obra que se puede hacer en otro lugar.
I'd like you to work on our workers' rights. Pete, which one do you, legalization? Which one do you want to take on? Reuniting families.
My name is Merlina Santala. I work as a housekeeper at Sheraton Waikiki Hotel. I am a member over here, Local 5, from Hawaii.
Because America's values, strong families, our immigration system, annually awards the majority of immigrants' visas and the basis of family ties.
Ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
If we have the solidarity as we did when we were stopped in the board, then there's nothing to stop us from, you know, achieving our goals. This is really something. It's, you can call it, history in the making.
Allá está la estatua, allá, mire. Allá lo está viendo desde acá. Allá está, ¿ven? Allá en la esquinita. Allá está, ¿ven?
Muchos no podemos alcanzar eso. Muchos nos quedamos a medio camino. Y pues en representación de todos ellos, yo creo que para mí, tanto como para mí como para Petrona, esto es un sueño. Y yo lo que yo voy a hacer es empezar a hablar con toda la gente que yo me encuentre a mi paso, con todas las personas que recién lleguen o que hayan estado aquí años. Y yo creo que por el resto de mi vida va a ser ese mi trabajo.
Estamos en New York.
Sí.
Oh, my God.
Shack Farmers Market.
Oh, I love it there.
I look at it just like one of me. I used to walk here.
This is your bar.
Buy food and take on the subway and go home.
This is downtown New York, and we are at the corner Hudson and Chambers Street.
Subway train!
The New York subway.
Amazing, New York! All the way from Hawaii to New York. I don't know how it happened.
Estamos en Nueva York.
Estamos en la lucha. Ahí la llevamos, vamos a ganar. No tienen que hacer caso. A eso venimos, para que exigirles. Ya no pedir, a exigir. Ya lo merecemos.
Hemos tenido grandes logros y vamos a seguirlos teniendo.
Koi, koi, koi. That's a Cantonese of Sisa Prede. Yes, we can do it.
All right, we made it all the way.
That's right.
Say this with me now. We have no fear. We will not hide. We are the Americans. Se puede. Se puede. Si se.
I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day, this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.